Welcome to Foreign Talk, exclusively from IMN. Today, we are very pleased to have Canadian Ambassador to Baghdad, Mr. Paul Gibbard. Mr. Ambassador, thank you for having us.
Thank you so much for this opportunity to talk to you and to connect with you and your audience.
Thank you so very much. Thank you for having us. If you kindly enlighten our viewers on your objectives and the goals of the Canadian Embassy currently in Baghdad, as far as the people are concerned, there is kind service providing beside obviously the diplomatic relationships between the Canadian and the Iraqi governments.
We're involved in a number of different areas.
Yes,
so
sir.
One of them that people may know about is the support that we've provided to Iraq in the fight against Daesh.
Yes.
So we've got some folks here, both military and civilian, as part of the coalition. And there's a new NATO training mission that we're part of.
Mm-hmm.
But apart from that, we've got an important program in terms of humanitarian assistance, helping those people most affected by the crisis, by the fight against Daesh.
Mm-hmm.
We have an important stabilization program, so that helping those people after the crisis to knit communities back together again,
yes, sir,
to deal with the aftermath. There's important, we're looking longer term in terms of development assistance as well.
Mm-hmm.
And apart from that, we're looking at how we can build better trade links between the two of us. What are things that we can, to mutual advantage, we can work on together on the trade side. And of course, not last but not least, are the people-to-people ties that are really important. We have an important Iraqi-Canadian community in Canada that's making a huge contribution to our country, and they can make a real contribution to that relationship between us.
We can see there are a range of varieties of, elements you are working with the Iraqi people, Iraqi government on this matter to help all aspects. But we saw the present, diplomatic present for the Canadian government in Iraq, it was unfortunately behind the other missions. There was the diplomatic, you think, or it was political reasons for it, or because of the security issues? What was the reason for this delay, if you call it delay?
Sure. We've always been here. There's always been a Canadian presence.
Right.
We may have had an ambassador in Amman for a number of years, but starting in 2016,
yes,
we developed a new Middle East strategy.
Mm-hmm.
So there a real focus on how we could engage, among other things, better in this region.
Yes,
so the reason I'm here is as part of that that Middle East strategy, and I'm really happy to be here, and it's a real privilege to be here.
You say this, we are working obviously as a diplomatic mission to strengthen the relationship. Does that the current official delegation came to Iraq, and I believe they met a couple of Iraqi officials, like the president, for example. This is also working hand by hand to strengthen this relationship, or there is certain work schedule behind that visit?
So we had our governor general visit last week,
correct.
And she's the equivalent
of
your president.
Correct.
She's also the commander in chief of our armed forces, so she has a couple of different roles.
All right.
And so it was really important for us. The very first thing that she did arriving in Iraq was to go to meet your president.
Correct.
Really to underline the fact that we respect Iraqi sovereignty.
Mm-hmm.
We understand that we're partners and guests here, and that we want to work closely with you. And that they had a very good meeting, I think. There are two people who have a lot of experience in a lot of different fields.
Okay.
Our Governor General is a former astronaut. So she's seen the Earth from space and has
picture.
Yeah, she has that bigger picture, that
right.
ability to say, how can we transcend differences? How can we transcend boundaries? Because we are one planet,
correct.
And we have to figure out how to work on that. So they discussed a variety of topics, they connected well. The president was very generous with his time, and we're grateful for that. They talked about a couple of themes that are key ones for our work. Pretty much everything that we do in Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
One has to do with gender and gender equality.
I will touch base on this. I believe the Canadian government focusing a lot on this, special women empowerment. I will talk about
perfect. Yeah. And they also talked a bit about governance, another theme that's important.
Yes.
And just how we can. They talked about education. Both of them have a real interest in that as well.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the underlying themes there was how can you bring people together. together. Her vision as an astronaut, you know, that vision of the world is a place where we need to come together.
Okay, in that aspect, you mentioned how to get the people together. The Iraqi people asking, there is a official channel, official websites. If the Iraqi, there are some Iraqis interested to go to Canada, obviously, for official businesses. Some of them are business people, some of them, I don't know, scholars. They are interested to go to your country. There is ways to go there, or strict so far?
So there's two things we maybe should distinguish between. One is people who are going to Canada to visit,
yes,
and the other is people who are going to immigrate. And mm-hmm. we have an important Iraqi community in Canada.
Yeah.
I met with them and the some of the business leaders before I came here.
Right.
We are a country that is based on diversity and inclusion.
Mm-hmm.
That Iraqi community is making a really, really valuable contribution to who we are as Canadians.
All right.
And so we're really, really thrilled to have them there.
But you give a visa, sir, in your embassy, or not yet?
So there is a process if you want to immigrate. There's also a process for applying for visas.
Yes.
We're not big enough here yet to have a visa section.
All right.
That visa section is still in Amman, and it takes a long time. So if you're planning to travel to Canada, mm-hmm. please apply with lots of time.
Yeah, I'm just getting the people's voice to you. That's
yes,
they have
thank
asked
you.
Me to ask you. That's yeah. why I clarify.
Thank you.
As far as the immigration, also Iraqis obviously are eligible to apply.
Of course.
And there is certain points to it. There is a website we can.
There's
get
a website, yeah, and that website's very helpful in terms of helping you sort of you know go through and see what
steps to follow. It's
exactly.
Excellent. As far as you touched base earlier about the delegation has emphasized the cooperation between the Iraqi government and the Canadian government as far as the military concern. You're present currently, obviously, working with the coalition forces concerning only training, or there is other elements as equipment or any other side of it also you provide the Iraqi government with?
So we have an important contribution in the coalition.
Yes.
We also have an important contribution in the new NATO training mission.
All right. So can you enlighten us on this?
Sure.
Yeah,
so there's a new NATO training mission.
Yes.
The first commander is a Canadian.
Mm-hmm.
In both cases, where we've got a Canadian presence in the coalition or
yes.
in NATO, one of the key roles really is about training.
Mm-hmm.
It's about building Iraqi capacity.
Yes.
It's about strengthening the Iraqi security sector.
Yes.
Basically, because to make Iraqi armed forces and
yes.
Iraqi security and Iraqi policing stronger and more effective.
Yes.
So we really work through those areas. We've got, for instance, the coalition's gender advisor
mm-hmm.
is a woman.
Yeah.
A Canadian, a senior Canadian police officer who's,
right.
who's here. Oh. And so we're working through a variety of different ways.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, we've been doing some training on community policing,
mm-hmm.
bringing policing closer to people.
Yeah.
And that's really the theme. How do we build Iraqi capacity?
Yes.
And how do we bring basically these very important activities closer to people and people feel that support that they need.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And also one of the very important element, obviously, is the agriculture aspect. Touch base with the Canadian officials on that. I believe Canada as a country has a great experience in such matter. And Iraqis, obviously, we have the foundation for such
yeah.
a thing. But we need better management in a way. There is the contribution, advice from the Canadian government towards agriculture or even industry in Iraq to reform, rebuild something. We need something to revive our country, as you know,
yeah.
I believe.
There are a number of areas in terms of that trading relationship.
Yes, sir.
There are a number of areas where we can work together. One of them is the oil and gas sector.
All right.
Both Canada and Iraq have enormous reserves of oil and gas and a lot of experience.
Canadian companies currently operating in Iraq?
There are some Canadian companies currently
Iraqing,
and we hope that there will be more as well.
We hope so.
We want to share some
of that. It's a mutual interest for both countries.
Exactly.
Yeah,
as far as agriculture, there's
mm-hmm.
certainly for some time,
yes.
Iraq has purchased agricultural products from Canada.
Oh, right.
So you have this wonderful, wonderful stretchy bread that I love.
Oh,
and that Canadian wheat can help to make that bread stretchier.
Yeah.
We want to have a closer trading relationship.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that will make that work better and it will make it easier mm-hmm. is economic reform. Corruption is an enormous issue for foreign companies, and it's one of the things that discourages sometimes foreign companies.
Unfortunately, yeah, you're absolutely right. But our Prime Minister, Mr. Abdel Mahdi, emphasized the urgency of such a matter, and it must be tackled as a priority for the government.
Indeed.
Corruption is obstacles for everything, investment, for normal life, for an ordinary citizen.
Yes,
that's an issue. I think it has been emphasized also by our government. Hopefully it will be solved in near future. In any case, you have also mentioned earlier, we touched base on your assistant in the rebuilding, assistant in the Daesh, the areas has been affected by Daesh. Can you enlighten us also more on that aspect, please, on that point?
Sure. So we've been providing some significant funding in terms of the humanitarian assistance. So in the immediate aftermath of that crisis, those people that are most affected, helping them right away. That's the humanitarian side of it. And then there's a question of what do you do after that? So mm-hmm. it's the stabilization part.
Yes.
So how do you get rid of
integration? There is programs for Canadian government on that?
Well, there's four things maybe we're doing on stabilization. One of them is helping to clear away the mines and other mm-hmm. explosive devices.
All right, that's a military aspect.
That Daesh, it's mind clearing. So it's a variety
it's
of different
organization, civilian organization.
Different organizations
uh-huh.
are helping
contributing
with that.
Also.
Yeah,
are Canada involved in it?
Yes. Yeah, we're helping to fund that. A second
mm-hmm.
is getting services up and running again, whether it's medical services or mm-hmm. other services, so that people have those basic services
basic
we need.
Needs, yes.
They need. A third has to do with community policing. So
mm-hmm.
providing we have some experience sort of bringing police close to the community, making sure those folks are completely integrated. So we've been doing some work in terms of community policing. And so those are three areas on the stabilization mm-hmm. side that we're working on. And then we also have some work sort of longer term,
mm-hmm.
sort of looking to the future. How do we build communities? And that's maybe a constant theme. How do you knit communities back together
mm-hmm.
after they've been pulled apart? How can you work with people?
Unfortunately, this scar is very big. As far as you mentioned the humanitarian aid to such affected areas as Mosul and other areas also, what do you meant by humanitarian? I mean, there is finance provided to the people, or there is what kind of help?
Exactly. So to make sure that they've got shelter, that they've got food, that they've
mm-hmm.
got water, that those very basic needs for mm-hmm. the people most affected are met.
We'll take a short break. I'll be right back. Please stay with us. Welcome back. Mr. Ambassador, we have touched base on the security and stability of Iraq itself. And I believe such an element is very important for investment. There are some aspects, or there are some people are interested in investing in some companies, private sector, the government itself, investing to their investments going towards Iraq with the change of the situation, security situation, everything.
There's
in the near future, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully. There are definitely Canadian companies in a variety of sectors that are interested in investing.
Yes.
And you know, we work with them to see what we can do. Economic reform is so important.
Mm-hmm.
We talked a little bit about the issue of corruption.
Mm-hmm.
Those economic reforms really create the environment where more of those companies are going to feel comfortable and interested and excited about coming.
As far as the stability in our region, you know, the situation is not that stable. There are so many countries, the security situation is unstable there. The cooperation between the Iraqi government and the Canadian government also focusing on such elements because the stability of a region as a whole obviously will affect each and every country in that region.
So one of the reasons that I'm here now is because of a decision that the government of Canada took in 2016 to take a global approach to this region. And it, we call it our Middle East strategy. It focuses on particularly the conflicts in Syria and in Iraq and the impact that those conflicts have on places like Jordan and Lebanon as well. So it's a comprehensive approach. One of the key parts of that is diplomatic engagement and how can we engage with key actors. And so I'm here just as a demonstration of the importance of this region, the importance of the relationship with Iraq.
Okay, excellent. Hopefully the future will be better for everyone. As far as our experience, unfortunately, we're very new towards the democratic aspect of ruling and all. And Canada has very long experience in such a matter. There is also democratic institutes or any kind of assistance, advice has been provided sorry, by your country to the Iraqi government and the Iraqi NGOs maybe in that aspect. Also, you guys tackling such a matter?
There's three areas where we're working, and it's one of our areas of focus, sort of the whole issue of governance. One of the
including democratic aspects.
So one of the things that we're working on, both Iraq and Canada are federations. And so we have some experience, some things that have worked well as a federation, some things that we could have done better. And so we're working with the Iraq government, both at the federal level and the provincial level, on decentralization. So it's bringing together those key people at both levels that are working on these issues, getting them together to do some training together to talk about how to actually make it work. They go off and do their work, they come back together, talk about how that went. So decentralization, bringing government closer to people, is one of the areas where we're helping. A second area where we're helping is this whole issue of how do you knit communities back together again. So we've been doing a fair amount of work with women across the country. One of the things that is really interesting around the world is that when women are involved as peacemakers, as mediators, they're involved in the peace process, that peace lasts longer. There's actually sort of studies around the world, and that perhaps the quality of that peace is better. So one of the things that we've been working on is this issue of knitting communities back together. And then a third area is the issue of women. I've had the opportunity.
Women empowerment, I believe, is an issue for.
I've had this amazing opportunity to meet women leaders, whether in government, in the private sector, in civil society. And there's so many, and they are so they're strong, they're smart. They have so much to offer. And so figuring out how to make sure that Iraq benefits from that, that they have those opportunities is really
important. As far as the woman empowerment to all kind of aspects of life beside the peace process, the Canadian government also involved in it?
Absolutely. So the peace part we talked about a little bit. We've been also working quite a lot on women's economic empowerment, the involvement of women in the workplace, as entrepreneurs. The number of women currently sort of working is quite low, and there's enormous potential for benefits for everyone, for growing the Iraqi economy, benefits for families, for communities, for the government. And so just about a week ago, we helped to sponsor a major conference in Beirut, and that event will take place next year in Jordan, and the year after here in Iraq. And so one of the things our Prime Minister says is that working on these issues of gender and gender equality aren't just the right thing to do, they're the smart thing to do. Because there's so many benefits for everyone when you have when you take advantage of the enormous potential that women as well as men have.
If we're looking for objective and impartial countries as Canada, the Canadian-Iraq relationship, in your place in the world and our place, you think we can play some role as peacemaker or peacekeeper somehow in our region? It would be useful somehow?
I think that every country has something unique that they bring,
yes,
based on their history, mm-hmm. The dynamics within their country. In the case of Canada, mm-hmm. A couple of those things, one of them has to do with we've been very fortunate in being able to create a society where diversity and inclusion are respected.
Yes,
in our largest city, Toronto, mm-hmm. more than 50% of the people who live there were not born in Canada.
Mm-hmm. Immigrant.
They're immigrants. They mm-hmm. come from all different parts of the world, mm-hmm. and so you know that kind of vision is part of who we are. And something that we've focused on for a long time is the importance of building coalitions, mm-hmm. of finding ways in which we can find others who share our values, our interests, in working together with them. Mm-hmm. Iraq has this incredible history,
yes.
Is at this pivotal place in the region, mm-hmm. and has without any doubt a lot to offer.
As far as we know, there are more than 200,000 Iraqis living in Canada currently. I believe they all legal status and everything. This community is not very small. You think they will contribute somehow in the future also to build bridges, stronger, more ties between the Canadian and the Iraqi people? And what are their contribution in your community as far as your personal judgment is?
They're already contributing.
Right,
so they're there, they've been there, some of them have been there for a generation or two,
mm-hmm.
And they're making important contributions to our country, whether it's in culture, or business, mm-hmm. or politics. They're there, they're present, and they're part of who we are as Canadians.
Excellent.
And that relationship, they can also work as a bridge.
Mm-hmm.
There's a number of Iraqi Canadians that I know here in Baghdad in Iraq, and mm-hmm. They're wonderful people, and they're helping to build those links between our two countries as well.
Excellent, excellent. Who is the best for your country and our country? Obviously, our cooperation. Thank you very much, dear sir. Would you like to have a final word for us, for our viewers?
I just want to thank you very much. It's a real opportunity to be able to talk to you, to talk to your audience, and look at how we can build this stronger relationship between us.
Thank you so very much. We're very kind, sir. Thank you very much. That was our interview with His Excellency Ambassador of Canada to Baghdad, Mr. Paul Gilbert. Thank you. I will see you next time. Thank you, sir. You're very kind.
Thank you.